You know what? He gave a warning immediately. He said, "Waman arada an zikri," when I send my guidance, whoever throws it aside and decides to live with another guidance, fa inna lahu ma'ishatan donka, such a person is going to live a restless and narrow life. And it says, "Wanashurum ya malkiyamat ama," are we even raising blind on the day of judgment? And he's going to complain to me that, "My Lord, why have you raised me a blind man? I could see when I was in the world." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, "Yes, my verses were read unto you. You turned away from it. Today, we are turning away from you." Now, after sending the guidance, you know, he said, guidance is coming. He named it Al-Huda. Don't forget, Al-Huda. That's the name, guidance. Now, the one who promised that the guidance was coming also announced the arrival of the guidance by himself. For you to know that it has arrived. And those are the verses we use for our Wulima. Allah says, Alif Lam Mim, Zalika Likitab, La Raiba Fihi, Huda, Lili Mutakin. The Huda that I promised was coming has come. That is the Quran. And when he gave us theory, he immediately assist us with the practical aspect of it. So he did not just send the law, he sent someone to come and live it, to come and live the life of the Quran, so that you would not say that what is happening to me, did it happen to him? So he gave us Muhammad. So that all that you will complain of would have happened to Muhammad. Your dad died, he lost his dad when he was in the womb. Your mom died, he lost his mom at the age of 6. Your wife is barren. Several women did not give birth to anyone for him. Hafsa was not fertile. Aisha did not give birth. Zainab did not give birth. So that you will not come to think that, why is it happening to me? Oh, you lost your child, he lost 6 children. You know, we gave you the example of Muhammad so that you will not grieve. And you know that if all those things that we think of are the objects of achievement in this world, they are meant to make us capable of being remembered later in life. Allah says, no, it is not your children that will make you capable of being remembered, not your houses, not your mansion, not your positions. Muhammad never had any of this. But today is the most remembered human being in the history of the world. The most celebrated. Because even after Allah has afflicted him, on the 8th day, for instance, he lost his remaining son. And the world was making jest of him. But Allah replied, if it's about your remembrance, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, I will raise your remembrance for you. Now, do you know why I have started this way? Because there will be misinterpretation and misunderstanding of Islam, because today you have Muslims without Islam. You have Muslims without the Quran. You have Muslims who are so confident about their Islam without applying the Quran, without applying their deeds. It is not possible. One of the mistakes we make is to misinterpret Islam as a religion. It is not a religion. Islam is a way of life. I'm going to explain this. You know, when you have different sectors in your life, this is, it's like, you know, I am here now. I'm a honorable commissioner in the Ministry of Home Affairs, Lagos State. The immediate thing that comes to your mind is, what have you got to do with lecture again? Why don't you leave that to the Alfas? Then I'll quickly remind you, Allah says in Quran 22 verse 41, referring to the governor, referring to the vice chancellor, referring to people who have been elevated. Our Father, may Allah continue to elevate you. Because you see, when I was reading something yesterday, they said the 13 university vice chancellor. The first I was looking for, Allah Majaki University of Lagos, one day. Alhamdulillah. At least you started well and you will end well, inshallah. You know why? You mustn't get to the position of a governor and then think that there was something you used to do as a Muslim which you cannot do again. No, it would never happen. Surah Al-Hajj says, Alladina immakannahum fil ard, The believers are those who, when they are established firmly on the earth, they become president, they become ministers. What do? Aqamu salat. They continue with their salat. Wa ataw zakat. They continue with their zakat. Wa amaru bil ma'ruf. They continue preaching. Kabirullah. They continue to command what is good. And they continue to forbid what is evil. You know, it is easy for anyone who doesn't live the life of the Quran to accuse me. What else are you still doing with microphone? But for those of you who understand that verse, see, he is doing what Islam says. And that is why you have the criterion, a noble organization of women of timber and caliber, and caterpillar. That's the way we say it. If you still have all that you have attained, and then you are propagating Islam, you have only followed Surah Al-Hajj, verse 41. Do you know that many people will tell you, don't bring this issue of religion, this is economy. You tell them that Islam, Allah says in Quran 17, verse 89, talking about the Quran, وَلَقَدْ صَرَفْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. Allah says, we have fully explained to mankind in this Quran every similitude, every example. He says, مَا فَرَتْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. I have not left anything unsaid in the Quran. One beautiful thing about the decree of Allah is Allah does not punish without sending messages. Says, وَمَا كُنَّ مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نُبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. Allah is not like Nigeria, for instance, that will pass a law. You know, you pass a law in the Senate or in the House of Representatives for 150 million Nigerians, and then the people are not aware of the law. And then after passage, after the president has assented, you are not going to print this law and give it to all Nigerians in their languages and take it to their doorstep for them to understand, to the extent that if any Nigerian who is unaware that it is a law eventually violates it. And then he tells you, I do not know. Do you know what we say? We say ignorance of the law is no excuse. So that is a country that is seeking the favor of Allah. Because you are unjust to someone whom you did not inform. Allah says, no, I will not do that. I will not punish you. Hatta nubuwwata rasula until I have.